deciding to speak publicly to us this morning at what must be an incredibly difficult time for her and her family. Next to Ishido-san is our regular interpreter, Takamatsu-san, who's kindly agreed to come along at very short notice. And at the end of the table is Teddy Jimbo, who you all know as president of Video News here in Tokyo. Just a couple of administrative things. If you could, please switch off your mobile phones or at least turn them to manner mode. I'll give you some guidance about questions and answers a bit later, but we're going to start with Ishido-san reading a brief statement. Thank you very much.
本日は大変お忙しい中を貴重なお時間を取っていただきましたことを感謝申し上げて一生忘れません。私は石戸純子と申します。ジャーナリストである後藤健二の実の母親でございますが、日本国民、そして日本政府の方々、そしてここにお集まりの方々に感謝とご迷惑をおかけしますこと、お詫び申し上げます。
Thank you so very much. Hello, thank you so very much for taking time out from your very busy schedules, taking your precious time to attend this press conference this morning. I will never forget your kindness today. I am Junko Ishido. I am the actual mother of Kenji Goto, who is a journalist. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Japanese people, the members of the Japanese government, and all of the persons assembled here today. I thank you for your great kindness, and I apologize for the tremendous inconveniences and troubles that my son has caused.
I have been in this 3 weeks. I have been in my life. What kind of thing?起こっているのか全く計り知れませんでした。そのために皆さんに大変お忙しい中をご迷惑をおかけしてますこと、心よりお詫び申し上げます。昨日ですね、賢治の妻である嫁と初めて電話で交信いたしました。で、聞きますと、嫁が聞きますと、に聞きますと、2週間前に赤ちゃんが生まれたそうです。で、私はびっくりいたしました。生まれたばっかりの2週間しか経ってない子供を置いて、なぜ遠いところへ行ったのですかと質問しました。そうしましたら、先に拘束されている知人を助けるために、救出するために 何が何でもという形で飛んでいってしまったと申しておりました。で、私はその時感じたのですが、この地球は大切にしなければいけない、たった一つ私どものために神が作ってくださいました、自然が作ってくださいましたものを、なぜその貴重なプレゼントを壊すのか私には分からないのです。原子力を使い地球を汚し、大気圏も汚して、そして何を求めようとするのか私には全然分かりません。で、今日こうやって皆さんにお会いすることも、どこで聞いたのか、私の近いところからはこの会見をやめるようにという電話がいっぱい入っております。しかしそれは間違いだと思います。皆様がお忙しい中、人類のために、そして身近では私どもの拙い息子のために、お忙しい中をお時間を作ってくださったものですから、感謝を申し上げる、これが当たり前ではないかと思いまして、電話を無言で切らさせていただきました。まあ、はい、
Over the past 3 days, I simply cannot understand what has been happening. And when I consider again how much my son has inconvenienced and caused trouble for so many, many persons, I would like again to take this opportunity to apologize from the bottom of my heart. Yesterday, I had the opportunity to speak with my son's wife for the first time in a very long time, and I was very surprised to learn that a baby had been born only 2 weeks old, and yet my son had left this very, very young baby to go and leave his family. And I asked my son's wife why he had made this decision, and the response was that my son had felt that he had to do everything in his power to help try to rescue a friend, an acquaintance that was very important to him. I felt very strongly that this world is something very, very precious, and this is what I've been trying to teach my son all his life. This world is something that God or the powers above have given us. It is something that nature has created for us. We cannot allow it to simply be destroyed. It is a precious gift that we must do everything in our power to try to preserve. I know there are many people who, for example, have created and used nuclear energy in negative ways, who have polluted the environment, etc. Sometimes I cannot understand what it is that people are trying to achieve in this world. When I made the decision to attend this press conference today, apparently news of my decision traveled to other people as well, and I received many phone calls, even in the anteroom just before I came, from people very close to me who strongly urged me to not go through with this press conference. But I felt that kind of a decision, that kind of a thinking was a mistake from the point of view of humanity, from the point of view of wanting to express my apologies for the great troubles and anxieties and inconveniences my son has caused so many people. I felt I needed to come here and speak in person and to apologize. So even though I was urged just before I came into this room by someone on the phone, I simply did not respond, and I cut off the phone call.
はこの3日間ただただ何が起こっているのか分からず、悲しく迷っておりました。ケンジはどういう子供であったかと申しますと、小さい頃から、それもまだよちよち歩けない頃から、幼いそういうお友達がいますと、いつもいつも心優しく接していた子どもです。 ですから自分のところにまだ出産したばかりの奥さんを置いて、そして生まれたばかりの血のみごを置いて出かけていったのだと思います。昨日その奥さんと名乗る方と初めて電話で交信いたしました。そして私が驚いたのは、赤ちゃんを産んで2週間にもまだ経っていないということなんです。私は賢治に憤りを感じました。なぜそんな血のみごを残しながら行くのかということ、友達が友人がと言ってもその2週間しか経っていない子供を守ってあげるのは親しかないじゃないですか。心優しい子、正義感に燃えている子と申しましても、なんかそこのところがちょっと下せませんでした。それともう一つ、私が
This occurred, and since these past 3 days, I have been filled with such tremendous grief and confusion, and so perhaps my mind is quite confused. But today I want to talk about what kind of child Kenji was, even before he could walk, even when he was still just basically tottering on his little feet. Whenever he would be with other children, he would always show great kindness to them. So I believe that he always cared about other people. And as I mentioned earlier, yesterday, I for the first time had an opportunity to speak with the young woman who is his wife. And I was very surprised to hear that a baby had recently been born, and to hear that my son had left a 2-week-old baby, even though he wanted to rescue his friend. My first reaction was a great anger at my son, because when a baby is just born and very weak and fragile, it is only a parent that can protect that baby. So I think he should not have left. But again, I understand that my son is a person that is filled with great kindness toward other people, who feels a great sense of justice, and that is why he took the decisions that he took. But still, I cannot quite come to terms with some of the decisions that he has made here.
私は不思議でならないことがございます。それは自分たちの地球を自分たちの手で壊すということです。原子力、原子爆弾、そういったものを研究して私どもが感謝しなければいけない地球を壊していく。そしてそこで生活している弱者を悲しみに落とし穴に突っ込んでいく。そのエネルギーがあったら世界平和のために、そしたらそれからこれから地球を守っていく、そういった課題になる将来を抱えた子どもたちのためになるような原子力であり、考えを持つべきだと非常に思っております。で、私が今こみ上げてくる涙を隠しておりますが、そのまま語っておりますが、それは先ほど申しました原子力の問題です。地球もダメにする、お水もダメにする、すべてをダメにする、それを一時の感情でドンパチやるということ、それをぜひ阻止しなければいけないと、そのように思います。もし私の命がそれで、そういう原子力とかの いい方の活用じゃなく、法のためになるのであれば、私は私の命を失うということも全くいといません。それはこの席ではっきりと申し上げます。
So, yeah. Many, many things occur to me as I speak before you today. And again, I do have this theme in my mind that the world is very, very precious, and it's what I've been teaching my children over the years. I believe that the world, some people in the world are moving in the wrong direction and destroying this very, very precious world that makes me think of another topic that is very dear to my heart, which is the concern that I have for future generations in regard to the misuse of, for example, things such as nuclear energy. I believe that if people, humanity has the resources and the abilities and the mental abilities to do research to create such weapons and such dangerous objects and use their great abilities to try to bring more pain, cause more pain to people throughout the world, then I would hope that such energies and such abilities be directed toward creating a better world for our children's future. I am very, very, of course, not quite myself today. I am weeping inside. I'm trying very hard to hide or hold back my tears. I realize that I might be repeating some things that I'm saying, but I believe that the world must be preserved for our children. I think we should think deeply about many of the difficult issues that face the world today, including the nuclear energy issues. If I can do anything, if I can sacrifice my life to help create a better world for our future, our children, I would very willingly do so.
Okay, Ishiro-san, thank you very much indeed. We're going to move to questions and answers. Just a couple of guidelines. I'll go to the members of the working press first. Please keep your questions brief and just one question at a time, please. And do come and speak into the microphone because we need to pick it up for the audio and video recordings. This gentleman here, I saw your hand up. Go up first. Please state your name and the name of your organization. Thank you.
おはようございます。インドネシアの新聞記者なんですけれども、インドネシアの新聞記者なんですけれども、リチャール・スシューロと申しますが、今の、状態なんですけれども、お母さんから何が、これから、締め切りは大体、日本の時間大体2時頃なんですけれども、何が考えてるんでしょうか、何が ISIS のメッセージにあるかどうか、ちょっと教えてください。お願いします。
I'm a newspaper journalist from Indonesia. In regard to the current situation, apparently a deadline has been given and it is a little after 2 o'clock today. What are your feelings as the mother of one of the hostages? Do you have a message that you would like to state for the Islamic State group?
イスラムの方々も私どもと一緒に地球の平和を考えて素晴らしい地球が作れるのであれば私の命などはどうなってもよろしゅうございますので、それと私はあんまりいい頭を持っていませんので、ぜひ皆様方からお知恵をいただければ本当に嬉しいと思います。そしてイスラム国の皆さんにも申し上げます。検事はイスラム国の敵ではありません。釈放を願って、そしてイスラムの単身で渡った子です。イスラムの国と一緒に恨みつらみはやめて、いい地球を作っていただければ、こ ここにお集まりの皆さんも皆さん全員の方々がそのような願いであると私は信じております。お忙しい中を本当にこのような席を作っていただいてありがとうございます。私の命で変えることがあるのであれば、私は自分の命を提出することに何の抵抗も感じませんので、ぜひ検事は正義感の強い子どもですから、釈放していただきました、もしそういういい結果が出ましたら、きっと地球のためにも子どもたちのためにも未来のためにも尽くしている子どもだと、尽くしていける子どもだと思います。どうぞ検事はイスラム国の敵ではなく、お友達、自分の2週間しか経っていない子供を置いてまではもうイスラムへ渡った人間です。日本は随一の被爆国ですが、被爆の後もその地球は惨憺たるものでした。こういったものは私の命と変えるのであれば、私の命なんていうものは粗末なものでございますので、悔いはいたしません。地球を大切にしていただきたい、私はそれだけを願っております。
I would like to speak to the people of Islam. I believe that if the people of the world, including the people of the Islamic religion, can come together, we can all work together to create peace throughout the world. I think we can work together to create a wonderful world. And as I've said repeatedly, I'm more than willing to sacrifice my life if such a goal can be realized. I apologize for some of my remarks. I'm not terribly clever. I'm not terribly smart. Yet, if you could please try to offer advice and knowledge that so many of you have to help try to resolve the situation, I would be so incredibly grateful. I would like to state clearly here that my son Kenji is not an enemy of the people of the Islamic faith. I can only pray as a mother for his release. My son has always been fascinated and interested in the world of Islam. That is why he has repeatedly visited Islamic nations. He bears no hate, no hatred for the peoples of the Islamic faith. In fact, he and I both share this great hope that people can stop hating each other and can work together for a common purpose. And again, I thank you so much for coming to here, and I repeat again, my life is a very small thing and not of great worth. If I can somehow offer my life up, I would pray that my son please be released, because that would be a very, very small sacrifice on my part. I believe, as I've said repeatedly, that my son is very kind and has worked hard to try to create a better world, to create a better future, to create better conditions for children. And I think if he is released and allowed to work, he will continue to offer great contributions to the world. Again, the Islamic people are not enemies for my son. He is so interested and so devoted to learning more about and being participating in the Islamic world that he abandoned his two-week-old baby to fly to Islamic nations. Japan has had a long and difficult past after the end of the war. It is the only country in the world that has been subjected to nuclear bombing, but even in spite of the terrible past that we have had, I think there are people like me, like Kenji, who have continued to work for greater peace.
David Hill.
Thank you, and thank you for coming here today for what must be a very difficult time for you. I wonder, just first of all, if you could tell us the last time... Oh, I'm sorry, David McNeil for the Irish Times. I wonder if you could tell us the last time that you had any communication from Kenji. And there have been reports in the Japanese press that ISIS communicated directly with you in some way. I wonder if you could confirm that as well. Thanks.
非常におつらいお気持ちの中で今日ご出席いただきまして誠にありがとうございます、恐縮でございますが一番最近、ケンジ様とその連絡を取られたのはいつ頃でございますでしょうか。日本の報道の一部の報道によりますとイスラム国、というその組織が直接お母様にもご連絡されたというそういうような報道があるんですが、それは事実でございますでしょうか。
ケンジは大変親思いの子供でございましたので、行く前には私のところに連絡はございませんでした。それはやはり一つは心配をさせたくなかったこと、もう一つは自分の同胞が捕らえられている、そこへ行くということは反対されるという思いだったのだと思います。でも私はそういうことに対して反対する親ではございませんので、今日もですね私の知人親戚から非常にこの場所に電話をもらっております。なぜこの会を出席するのか、それをやめろという通知でした。私はここに集まってくださるっていらっしゃいます方々は、すべてお一人でも私と同じ考えを持っていると思うのです。自分だけの利己的な幸せ、そういうことではなく、世界中の方たちが生活しているこの地球を守ること、そういうことを願っていると思いますので、そういうお話は全部断ってまいりました。それから日本は、私の父は軍人です。朝鮮とかそういうところの今ちょっと言葉が出ないのですが、かなりのトップだったと思います。それで私にはいつも軍用車と、それから三角形のひらひらする旗のある自動車で送られていました。しかし今は私どもは、ただ今はですね、写真を見ますと、その時に私のおじいちゃんなるもの、教育者なんですが、その人が本当に自分の姿で草履履きを履いて、私の朝鮮馬山の宿舎へ訪ねてきた。私はつい最近まで、おじいちゃん、なぜそんな格好でに、朝鮮へ来てくれたのって、恥ずかしいじゃないって、そういうような思いをしたことがありました。しかし最近分かったことは、ちゃんとした格好をしてくれば、家族とか、それから周りの人々に反対されたんだと思います。それで一目、息子に会いたかったその一心で、海峡を渡ってきたと思うんです。私もそういう切ない親の気持ち、そういうのが現在は非常によく分かると同時に、すべての地球上で住んでいるお母様方、どういう気持ちでいらっしゃいますか。 一生懸命母の手で育てて、そして戦争にやる、こういうことを少しも考える方はいないと思うんです。戦争はやめていただきたい。おいしい白米から麦ご飯に変えたとしても、それは母たちの喜びだと思うのです。どうぞ皆様のお力で賢治の命を救ってください。ただ私は自分の子供のことだけを言っているのではないのです。子供はユニセフとかそういった子供たちのことを非常に考えておりましたので、今度命あって帰るならば、日本はのみならず世界中を回って、やはり次世代を担う子どもたちの教育にも携わっていただきたい。そして原子力のない国を作っていただきたい。そんなあの言葉をかけてやりたいと思います。我が身を捨てることですね、つまり。
はい、Sorry, again, my mind is quite confused, so perhaps I'm speaking a little bit too much. But I believe that in this case, before Kenji, my son, decided to go abroad, he did not contact me. And I think that the reason for that is because he was very considerate of his parents' feelings, and he probably thought that we would be very, very anxious. Even though he was going for a very, very important cause to rescue his colleague, he thought perhaps that we might have opposed his going. But I am not a mother that would have opposed his going. Even today, as I mentioned earlier, relatives, acquaintances have called the FCCJ even just before I came into this room, saying that I should not appear. But I believe that what I'm saying, although I seem to be rambling a little bit, I believe that the things that I'm saying, I think that the fundamental feelings are shared by everyone in this room. There are people in this world who think perhaps only of their own selves, their own interests, but I think the majority of people in the world want to work together to create a better world. So I turned down the request from my relatives and acquaintances and decided to appear here. I'd like to talk a little bit about my own personal experiences as a child. My father was a member of the military, and we lived for a time in the Korean Peninsula. I cannot recall now his title, but he was a very important official, a fairly important official in the military organization. I just remember as a child being taken to and from places in a car with a military, triangular military banner at the front of the car. But when I look back on these old photos, at these old photos, I come across, for example, a photograph of my grandfather who came and visited us once, but he came dressed in a very casual style with just his slippers, sandals, and just regular clothes. I remember thinking it was very embarrassing to see my father's father come dressed so simply. Why didn't you dress up? I remember asking. But he said if I had dressed up and made a big deal of things, then everybody would have known that I was going to visit the Korean Peninsula, and many people, my family, would have opposed. But I wanted so much to be able to see my son. And at that time, when I was a child, I didn't understand what he was saying. But now that I am a parent, I understand the burning desire that a parent has to see one's child. But again, I'm not speaking just of my own self, but I believe that mothers throughout the world, you spend so much time and energy and love raising a child. You would do anything to protect that child. So I'm asking, please, that you save him, but not only just to save him as an individual, but as I've said before, he has always worked very, very hard to try to create a better future for future generations. If he is allowed to return, I am sure that he will continue his work for such organizations as UNICEF. He will work not only for Japan, but for countries throughout the world to help better the education for the next generation of children.
Thank you. My name is Stefano Carrer for the Italian Economic Daily Sole 24 Ore. What is your message for the Japanese government? I mean, would you urge the government to show flexibility in dealing with such a situation? There are rumors, for example, that the Italian government last week paid a ransom for freeing two Italian girls who were held captive in Syria. Not to the ISIS, and the ransom was small, but anyway, would you point out to the government that not all the governments are very, very strict in dealing with similar situations? Thanks.
Hi. 日本政府に、イタリアの記者でございます。日本政府に何かメッセージ、お願いなどはございますでしょうか。つまり、例えばできるだけ柔軟な体制を取ってもらいたいというようなお気持ちはございますでしょうか。私の国イタリアでございますが、最近身代金を払いました数人のイタリアの女の子が、女性がシリアで拉致されておりましたので、それを解放してもらうために、まあ、これはイスラム国というその同じ団体ではないんですが、身代金を払ったのでございます。つまり例えば日本政府に、国によっては、まあ、もっとその柔軟な態度、強固じゃない態度を取るところもありますよなどとお話をされますでしょうか。そういうようなメッセージを日本政府に、出しますでしょうか。
はい、今のお話は生意気かもしれませんが、検事のしたことはつまらないことと言われるかもしれませんが、しかし生まれて2週間も満たない赤子を置きながら同胞日本人の方の救出に向かったんです。ぜひともそういう優しい気持ちで言ったのではなく、もっとイスラムに対しても違う感情があったと思います。それはなぜかと申しますと、捨て身で言ったということですね。ということはやはりイスラムの国、そういうことにもいろいろと会ってお話をすれば分かり合える地球人たちだと判断したからだと思います。どうぞイスラムの方々も、日本人はみんな好意的に接していると思います。私もこんなことをこんな場所で、このような場所でお話をさせていただきまして、これほど海外のジャーナリストの方々が捨て身で息子のためにやってくださっています。そこから想像するならば、きっとイスラム国の中でもそういう方はいっぱいいらっしゃると思います。その時はぜひ日本に申し出てください。日本国もこの度後藤健二のこういった行為のためにお力を貸してくださったお国だと思えば、そう思えなくても日本は第二次世界大戦というものを体験しております。子どもが泣き叫び、体中が皮がむけて、そんな被災した無条件降伏をした国です。わからないことがないではありませんか。私の命とこの地球を守ることの取り替えがきくならば、私はこの身を捧げてもやはりきれいな地球を作っていきたい、子どもたちの未来を、素晴らしい教育者を育てながら、そして平和を考えて育てるならば、やっぱり子どもも喧嘩好きな子どもではなく、平和な心の子どもが育つのではないかと思います。もし、はい。
Perhaps it is out of place for me to say such grand things, but I believe very, very strongly that
the goals that my son had and the goals that I have for the world are very, very important. Kenji is a person who took actions that some may criticize as having been foolish. Again, I point out to the fact that he abandoned his two-week-old baby, to try to rescue a colleague, a Japanese colleague at that. And I think it was not simply that he had a kind heart that he made this decision. I think he realized the dangers that he was facing, that he was realizing that he was risking all to go to this very, very dangerous place. But I think the reason that he made this great decision was because he felt in his heart that if he were able to speak with the people of these Islamic nations, of these organizations, that they would be able to understand each other, that they would understand that people are all the same, that humanity all has the same goals, and that if we could all work together, we could create a better world. I would like to explain to the Islamic people of the world that all Japanese have a fundamentally very positive and friendly feelings toward Islamic nations. Again, I feel so honored and very humbled to be speaking just an ordinary person at such an important place. And I am so moved by the fact that so many journalists, especially from many foreign nations, are working so hard to try to find information to help my son. So I believe that it is not only people that are in this room that are working hard, but I think many people in the Islamic nations are also trying very, very hard to try to help resolve the situations. And if these people could please speak up and perhaps try to communicate with the Japanese government and try to help resolve the situation and save my son, I would be very, very grateful. I know I keep talking about things that seem sort of not directly related to this issue. However, we are a nation that has experienced World War II, and I have experienced in my own life the great suffering. I know how terrible it is to experience war and conflict. I've seen people with their skin falling off because they have been the victims of such great conflict. I think, I have tried to raise my children in a way that they think about the future, they think about the importance of protecting the world and children, and I hope that other people who feel the same way will join me in trying to help create a better world and trying to resolve this situation.
Okay, we have several hands going up at the same time, so I'm going to go to Joel and then Richard Lloyd Parry.
Joël Legendre, RTL France Radio and Television. The tears of a mother are certainly the most heartbreaking thing for anyone. And we know Islam respect women, they said so. And in France, this pen became a symbol of gathering of people to try to fight for freedom and respect of life. The tears of a mother is maybe the best weapon you have today to try to talk to them and tell them, those people who hold your kid, to liberate him. Could you make a statement that is not just something you read, but something from the bottom of your heart to try to gain the liberation?
はい、フランスの、ラジオテレビ、関係のジャーナリストでございます。やはりその、母親の涙というのはやはり見ている人たちは本当に心が裂けるような気持ちになるものだと思います。やはりイスラム教の、信者はやはりその、女性を、まあ、尊重尊敬しているというふうに言われているわけでございます。まあ、私の国フランスではやはり自分たちの考えを、まあ、デモなどを通じまして、あの一生懸命表しているわけでございます。今日は非常に特別な機会でございます。まあ、今までいろんなペーパーをご用意されたかと思うんでございますが、そうではなく、やはり母親の涙といいますのは最も強い、効果のある武器でもあると思いますので、そのお母様の心にある本当の正直な お言葉をその、今息子を拉致しておりますイスラム国の、という組織の方々に何か訴える言葉を言っていただけますでしょうか。実際に、その、彼を捉えている方たちにメッセージ、お言葉、お母様としてのお言葉を述べていただけませんでしょうか。
イスラムの方々にお願い申し上げます。私どもの子供であります後藤健二は 幼児にものを教えること、それから低学年から大学まで指導することを最大に得意としております。そしてイスラムのことは決して嫌いではなく、逆の人間だと思っておりますので、もし元気で帰ってきましたら、こういう国もイスラム国と共に歩んでいる、そして世界にはこういう科学の力を持っている国もいる、そして子どもを愛している、第一番に子どもの幸せを考えている、こちらにいらっしゃいます方々、そういう方々もいる、そういったことを少しはあちらの言葉も覚えてきているかもし、来るかもしれませんので、そういった世界平和のために身を尽くし、心を整えて学んでいく若者にしたいと思います。彼はお友達を救うために、今回のイスラム行きはお友達を救うために出発いたしました。ケンジは幼い頃から本当に弱い子供、そういった方々に優しい子でございました。
I want to take this opportunity to make a deep request to the people of Islamic nations. Our son, Kenji Goto, is a person who has devoted to his life and who is very, very adept at being able to teach young children. It brings him the greatest joy in his life to be able to guide and educate children from a very young age to until they enter college. He is not, if there is any misunderstanding, he is not in any way against the Islamic faith. He is the opposite of such a person. He has great respect and has great fondness and interest and is fascinated by the nations of Islam. I believe that he thinks from the bottom of his heart that if the Islamic world and the Japanese nation can come together and deepen their friendships, the world will become a greater place, a better place.There are many different nations in the world. There are different kinds of people in the world. Some people have great knowledge, some people have great skills, some people are more advanced in terms of technologies, and some people just think about the future happiness of children. I ask that my son please be allowed to return, because I believe that after his experiences, he probably will have come back having learned more of your languages, more about your cultures, and I think he will be able to pass that knowledge on to the children and young people thatHe guides and educates in Japan. I repeat again, he has no hatred, no feelings of enmity toward the Islamic nations. He only went to rescue a friend. That is the kind of person that he wants. From a very young age, he has always looked out for weak people. Even if he was a child, he would always take care of a child who was weaker than him. That is his greatest goal in life, to create a better world for everyone.
Yeah, I've already called Richard. Thank you.
Kenji は、
Richard Lloyd Parry of The Times. In 1977, Prime Minister Fukuda paid a large ransom to some hijackers. And at the time, he famously said that the life of a human being is heavier than the whole world.Don't you think that Prime Minister Abe should take the same approach and pay the demanded ransom to save your son, Mr. Yukawa?
イギリスのタイムズ紙です。1977年にハイジャック事件が起こりました。覚えてらっしゃると思うんでございますが、当時は福田首相でございましたが、彼はかなり大きな身代金を払って、釈放、人質の釈放を実現したわけでございます。その時に批判も、身代金を払ったことによって批判もされたんですが、福田首相が言ったことは、人命、人の命の価値は地球より重い と言ったと思います。やはりそのようなお言葉もやっぱり、安倍首相にも、思い出していただきたいとお考えでございますでしょうか。
はい、非常にそれを願っておりますと同時に、私は賢治も小学校中学校幼稚園それから大学までも教師をした人間でございますので、ぜひイスラム国で日本に勉強してみたいというお子さんがいましたら、ぜひ賢治に申し付けていただければ一級の指導をすると思います。賢治にとって日本はイスラム教諸国の敵ではなく友好関係の、そしてイスラムのお幸せを願う願っている私などよりも、そういった平和を願っているからこそ自分の知人が捕らえられたといえば、何を置いても2週間しか経っていない赤子を置いても飛行機で行ってしまった子どもです。この子どもですから、絶対イスラム国のにもそのようなご縁がございましたら、私も息子と一緒に全力を持って指定教育に当てさせていただきたいと思います。それから私の家も開放したいと思います。世界に精神のきれいな平和を求める子どもたちをいっぱい作っていきたい、それが私の願いでございますので、それはやはり賢治がいつも日頃口にしていた言葉だからこそ私の口を使って言わせているのだと思います。賢治は、はい、ありがとうございます。
Yes, I would certainly hope, I very, very dearly hope that Prime Minister Abe and the Japanese government does think about these previous kinds of examples. At the same time, I would like to mention that not only myself, but Kenji, from all of our educations, through junior high school, high school, college, we've all been educators. Our primary focus has been on education. And I believe that if Kenji is allowed to return to Japan and there are students, young people in Japan who want to learn more about the world of Islam, I would hope that they would contact my son, because I'm sure he would be able to give them the best possible education, the most in-depth information and knowledge about the Islamic nations. As I've repeatedly said, Japan is not an enemy country to the nations of Islam. It is a nation that has tried for many years to try to forge friendly, amicable relations with the Islamic people. It is because Kenji feels so strongly about this that he has left his two-week-old baby and tried to rescue a friend, all in the name of peace. That's the kind of child he was. I believe that through his experiences over the past few months, he has gained invaluable, unprecedented knowledge, in-depth understanding about the Islamic world. And I think that when he comes back to Japan, he will be able to use that for great purposes in educating future generations. I would offer up my own home to try to help in his educational efforts.
Khaldun.
Thank you. My name is Khaldun Asari. I'm originally from Syria. I noticed you said many words about Islam, and you want to explain to the world that your son is not against Islam. Are you aware that there are many reports, and almost 80% of the people, or 90%, they think that this so-called Islamic State has nothing to do with Islam, and it's just a bunch of mercenaries and criminals and losers, and et cetera, came from all over the world, and they are committing all kinds of crimes, and they control area that is left in chaos because of the situation there, and it's not really Islamic State, there's no state, nobody recognized it as a state, and there are even some people accused this state people, so-called state, that they are agents of international intelligence agencies and local intelligence agencies. So are you aware that the issue is not really Islamic issue? Thank you.
シリアの記者でございます。今までお母様はイスラムの方々というような話をずっとされているわけでございますが、今回、ご存知でございますでしょうか。その、検事、様が捕らわれております団体というのはイスラム国という団体なんでございますが、これは、イスラムの国々の中でも世界の人たちの中の8割9割はこれは本当は国家ではないと、別にそしてまたイスラム、その信者の本当がやるべきことを、信者がやるようなことを しないような団体だっていうふうに非難されている団体であるというのはご存知でございますでしょうか。つまり傭兵、お金をもらってそこで戦闘している人たちとか、他の国では犯罪者だったり、あるいはその自分の社会をうまくいかなかった人たちが集まってこのイスラム国っていうこの組織に入っている、そういうような組織であるということはご存知でございますでしょうか。そしてまたこれは例えばそこの地域のいろんな諜報機関の、実はエージェント、手先であるというふうにまで非難されている。つまり今まではイスラムの人々にってずっとお話をされているんでございますが、この団体は必ずイスラムの、を代表するものではないということはご存知でございますでしょうか。
ちょっとそこまでは存じ上げておりませんでした。失礼いたしました。でそのお話を聞いて、もしイスラムの方からお子さんが日本で勉強したいとか、そのような方がいらっしゃいましたら、私が全力を持ってお守りいたします。そして私のうちでしっかりとお勉強していただくことをお約束いたします。
I am sorry、I did not understand、very much about the nature of this organization、I really did not know these things. All I can say is that I'm speaking to the people of the Islamic faith, and my feeling is that when I said I would open up my home to help for the education of the next generation of children, I meant that if a person from one of the Islamic nations, a child, wanted to study in Japan, I would gladly welcome them into my home and take care of them and help them study.
We're running over time. You all have deadlines, so I'm going to give the last question to you. Go ahead.
日本語で質問したいと思いますので、私はロシア国営テレビのミンガジェフと申します。一つだけを聞きたいと思いますけれども、この3日間ではですね、日本政府から何かの連絡がありましたか。指導さんはですね、自分から日本と話してみていただけましたか。一つだけ聞きたいと思います。はい、
全く日本政府から云々ということとか、そういったものは全くございません。
So the question was from,
ですから今お約束すること、例えば皆様方の国から日本でを知りたい、学んでみたいみたいなお子さんがいらっしゃいましたら、日本国からは何のそういったお話もございませんが、ここで私のできる限りのことをさせていただくことをお約束させていただきます。
The question was from the Russian journalist, which was that over the past 3 days, have you received any specific concrete communication from the Japanese government? And the response is, I have received no communication from the Japanese government, no instructions, no nothing at all. So I'm here as an individual, as the mother of one of the hostages. And what I can say as an individual here is I can promise that I will do everything in my power to, as I said, accept children from Islamic nations who might want to study in Japan. This is a very small thing that I can do, but it is the most that I can do. This is what I would like to promise here today.
Okay, thank you. We've had a request from several people for Ishido-san to read the statement from start to finish, because I don't think that happened earlier on. So we're going to end with that. I'm sorry, I know many of you have got questions that went unanswered, but I'm sure you'll understand that we can't answer every single question.
これ読んでほしいっていうことで、 立ちます。私は日本人の石戸純子と申します。私の得意分野は子どもたちの教育と、それから医学についてです。ジャーナリスト、
これをそのまま読んでほしい。
あ、そうですか。
これです、これです、
はい。ジャーナリストの後藤健二の実の母親でございます。多くの外国人記者の皆さんにお集まりいただき感謝に耐えません。日本国民、日本政府の皆さん、諸外国の皆さんに検事が大変ご迷惑をおかけしていることにより、ことに心よりお詫び申し上げます。もう二度とこのようなことをさせないように私も教育をし直さなければと思っています。私はこの3日間ただただ悲しくて泣いているばかりでした。賢治は幼い頃から心の優しい子でした。賢治はいつも戦地の子どもたちの命を救いたいと言っておりました。ですからこそ、子どもが生まれて1週間しか経たないのに友人を助けるために行ってしまったのです。そして賢治の報道の特色は、常に中立な立場で戦争報道をしてきたと信じております。イスラム国の皆さん、申し上げます。賢治はイスラム国の敵ではありません。その反対によく知り合えば、本当にいろいろと助け合う人類の友としてお役に立てる人間だと思っております。日本は戦争をしないと憲法9条に誓った国です。70年間戦争をしておりません。私もこの部屋に入るとき電話をもらいました。今日はやめるべきだと。しかし私は断りました。みんな仲良くしたい、世界の平和を守っているからこそ諸先生方に集まっていただけたのだと思います。ですから私はそのまま続行させていただきますということで、丁寧に電話を切らせていただきました。もう一度申し上げます。日本はイスラム教諸国の敵ではなく、友好関係を保ってきた国だと信じております。まあ、それぞれの国がそれぞれの知恵とそれぞれの得意分野を持っていると思いますが、世界の皆さん、それをお互いに披露し合って、もっともっと素晴らしい地球にしていただきたいと思います。私はそんな力は持っておりませんが、もし私にそのような場面がございましたら、一生懸命勉強してイスラム語でも勉強してお友達になって、私の知っている知識でも一緒に学び返したいなと、そのような気持ちさえ持っております。日本は唯一の被爆国です。アメリカによる広島と長崎への原爆投下で数十万人が亡くなりました。あとを残された時間はわずかです。日本政府の皆さんもご自分の反省するべきところは反省し、直しながら国民と一体になって、そしてまたイスラム諸国と一緒に育てていく、学ぶ点があるならば、そういった方に戦力よりも持っていきたいと、そのように思います。もし私にそのような場を与えていただくことが、これは仮定ですが、としたならば、私は命に代えても 今までの私の経験を生かしてイスラム国のお子さんにも接していきたい、教えていきたい、そんな気持ちでおります。賢治は自分のために言ったのではない。どうぞそういった賢治の気持ちも、それからまた賢治の活躍も、もう一度賢治にそういう子どもたちへのお手伝いもさせていただくように、イスラム国の皆さんにもお願いしたいと思います。はい、ありがとうございます。
So my name is Junko Ishido, and I'm a Japanese person, and I'm the mother of the journalist Kenji Goto. I thank so many of you of the foreign press for coming here today. I thank you from the very bottom of my heart. And again, I would like to take this opportunity to apologize to the Japanese people, the Japanese government, people throughout the world for the great troubles and inconveniences and anxieties that the actions of my sons have caused. If he is allowed to return, I will re-educate him to never cause this kind of inconvenience to people again. Over the past 3 days, I have been weeping and not sleeping, and I cannot even express how much sorrow I have been feeling. As I've mentioned previously, Kenji, even as a child, has always been very kind to others. From a very young age, he has always wanted to rescue children, especially those in war zones. So that is why he abandoned his very young baby in order to try to save a friend. When I look at the kinds of articles that he has written, I think that the characteristic of his reporting has been that he always takes a neutral, fair, just stance. And I will repeat again that my son is not an enemy of Islamic states. If anything, he is very close to people of the Islamic faith, and he, I think, has... had this great opportunity to learn so much more and has probably been helped by many, many people in the Islamic nation. So I ask, please, that he be released. As you know, Japan has a very distinctive constitution. There is an article, Article 9, by which Japan has sworn never to wage war again. And over the past 70 years, since the end of World War II, Japan has never engaged in a war. When I entered this room, again, as I mentioned earlier, I did receive a call, several calls from people telling me not to appear at this press conference. But I believe that in spite of everything, I think that if people can understand what kind of person Kenji was, what his ideals were, what kind of good work he can contribute to the world in the future, then it would be better to attend this press conference and have people understand that. And I repeat again, Japan, neither Japan nor my son thinks of Islamic nations as an enemy. If anything, we worked very, very hard to create good relations. And again, I do not have much time left in my own life, but if I have an opportunity, I would like to do whatever I can personally, individually, to try to create better relations. I would try to study the languages of different nations. And Japan is the only nation that has actually suffered the effects of a nuclear bomb. Japan is a nation that has seen much tragedy and therefore knows directly how tragic war can be, especially for very, very young people. The time left for my son is very, very short. And I ask the Japanese government to please save his life. I ask the Japanese people, the Japanese government, to reflect on their past actions and to see what can be done to help resolve the situation in conjunction with the people of Japan, in conjunction with the people of Islamic nations. I believe that if my son is given a chance to be released, I would believe from the bottom of my heart that he will continue to work to create a better world, and I will do whatever I can in my limited capacity to do the same.
Okay, for the benefit of the TV cameras, Ishido-san is going to read the last paragraph of her statement again.
Japan は、あと残された時間はわずかです。日本政府の皆さん、賢治の命を救ってください。それとともに私はお約束申し上げます。イスラムの 子どもたちがもし日本に来て学びたいときは私のところを宿にしてください。大喜びでお受けいたします。
And again, I would like to make a personal promise again. If any children from Islamic nations wish to study in Japan, please come to my house. Please use it as a place to live. I would welcome you all with open arms. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Ishido-san, thank you very much again for having the courage to come and speak to us this morning. I know that everyone in this room will be hoping desperately that your son and Mr. Yukawa are released and that they return home safely. Thank you very much again for coming, and we wish you all the best. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for coming.
今日はお越しいただいて本当にありがとうございます。私にがお役に立てることがございましたら、命を変えても実行したいと思っております。このお約束は必ずさせていただきますので。Okay.日本にいらっしゃる子どもたちも多くなることを願っております。
Again, thank you for this very great opportunity, and I will stand by my promise regardless of what happens. If there are any children from Islamic nations who would like to study in Japan, I would welcome them with open arms into my home.
One last thing, please remain seated until Ishido-san and our other guests have left the room. Thank you.
すみません、皆様、石堂様がご退場されるまで皆さん着席のままで見送っていただければと思います。よろしくお願いいたします。
どうもありがとうございました。地球のために力を合わせて頑張ります。